I was searching recently for two NAS hard drives to replace my old Toshiba ones that are on their last leg, I believe. And I actually came across on eBay, came across two of these. There are more sellers that sell these. I'm not sure, you know, what's the story behind these, but basically they're not working, and as far as you can see, this is, I believe, the reason that's why they're not working, because they were vandalized or something. I don't know. I'm not sure. The seller states it's a return, store return. I don't know who returns hard drives like that. But anyway, you know, these are pretty recent hard drives, August 2019 on this one. And I bought these for $15 each, and they retail for about $100. I just checked, actually it's $110 on Amazon. So I decided to see, you know, if I can get them working, get them back to life, basically out of the landfill, and save some money along the way. So let's see if my project will be successful. So let's begin. I'm gonna use you can actually check it out. It's I got everything connected, so it doesn't work. There's no life, basically, because, you know, this is the spinning part, the motor that just get disconnected. And let's see, that's what I'm gonna use. I'm just gonna use this wire from the network cable, from CAT5E network cable, and let's see if we can get it soldered, and if we can get it going. So let's begin. Get this out of the way. Okay, so we're gonna use the T8 Torx screw driver. So this connector seems to be okay. So I'm just gonna try to solder wires. It's actually four wires, so it shouldn't be bad. And let's connect these connectors, these pins, and see what's gonna happen. I'm gonna have to clean it first. So you see what's happening here. I'm just cleaning the top layer, actually taking it off to the bare metal. I'm just gonna warm it up. It's it's about 340 Fahrenheit. Just gonna warm up this plastic part so I can get rid of it. Okay, so all the contacts get cleaned up. Let's go ahead and solder. Or solder. Whichever you prefer. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, this might be not the proper wire for the job, but I think it should be fine. Yeah, I think it should be fine. And pushing them down so they don't stick out. here. And I'm gonna check for short, make sure none of these wires are short into ground. You know, if they are, I'll probably need to pick up this little part up and add some insulation, but we'll see, maybe I'll be fine as is. Push them in and see if one of these is short into ground. Okay, I think we are fine. So I'm pushing down on the pins just to make sure the coating on these wires underneath is not gone and it's not touching the ground, but it seems to be fine. I think we are fine. So I'm gonna cover it with some coating after these contacts, but let's test it first and see if we get it fixed. Looks like we're good there too. So let's test. Эмиль, я тут видео снимаю. Эмиль, я видео снимаю, фить отсюда. It spins, so let's check it out. So just to follow up, the project was not successful. I had to test it in the proper enclosure. The disk management utility recognized it as 4 terabyte hard drive, but I cannot initialize it. It is giving me an error. The request could not be performed because of an input output device error. So if you guys planning to do the same thing I just tried, don't waste your time. Thanks for watching. Not successful, that's okay.